أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، جاء بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. فاللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى أصحابه وأتباعه ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى أثره إلى أن ترث ربنا الأرض ومن عليها. اللهم إنا أمسينا نشهدك ونشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك بأنك أنت الله وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. أما بعد، we have finished alhamdulillah since we started our halaqah the chapter of tahara, cleanliness, the way that رسول الله the way that we should be in tahara and how we perform our salah, how do we make the proper wudu like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there is many questions and many things in the chapter of At-Tahara we have gone through, alhamdulillah. And we finished as well the chapter of, who can remember? As-Salah, Jazakallah khairan. You still have your pen and mashallah and notebook, Jazakallah khairan. And we finished the chapter of As-Salah, alhamdulillah. And there is many questions around that chapter. And alhamdulillah, we have done that as well. Inshallah, today as Ramadan is almost there, there is a chapter in the middle that I see myself, it is an important chapter, but it is not as important as the chapter of As-Siyam. Because As-Zakah, the chapter that we are leaving is the chapter of As-Zakah. The chapter of As-Zakah, it is actually not everybody have to give Zakah. I might have money, I might have not. What is the zakah in Ramadan, the zakah for Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha? Oh, we all know that. Zakah is actually mostly its personal things. A brother have a land, a brother have a house, a brother have cars, a brother own this and that. This is related, usually, most of the time, it's personal things. But when it comes for Siyam, no. It is for everybody. Unless the person, Allah forbid, is sick. Unless the person have a surgery, unless the person have an excuse like the sister is having her period. So many different things, but everybody at the end of the day, as-siyam is farida for every single one. As-zakah is farida when you have the money. When you have it, the money. I might have my car and my house and that's it, khalas. What is the zakah? There is little things for zakah here and there. So as well as Ramadan is coming, inshallah, we're going to be starting the chapter of As-Siyam. As-Siyam meaning in Arabic, as the ulama say it, the meaning of As-Siyam is imsak, to hold yourself from something. To hold yourself from something. This is the ulama's explanation of the As-Sawm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah, so it could be from fasting, it could be from talking, it could be from your wife, it could be from anything. Just to hold yourself from something. So I could be. What is the proof? A Sayyida Maryam radiallahu anha, when she was holding Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command her not to talk. If somebody tell her anything, she say what? Inni nadartu lirrahmani sawma. Yes? A sawm here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her, if somebody talks to you, tell them that I'm fasting. Fasting from what? From talking. So fasting is not only fasting from eating and drinking. No, it could be from talking. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as Sayyida Maryam said on her tongue, when the people ask her, where did you get Isa from? She said, Inni nadartu lirrahmani sawma falan ukallima al-yawma insiyya. I have fasted for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am not going to talk to any human. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a reason behind that, for Sayyidina Isa to talk. So the meaning of fasting is mean to hold yourself from something. So this is the Arabic meaning. I imsakan an kalam, imsakan an al-muftarat. It could be with a niyyah, with niyyah. When it comes to siyam, it has to be niyyah. What is the benefit? What is the reward? What are the things that we get behind of the fasting? Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu qal, qal Allahu azza wa jal. This is hadith قدسي حديث قدسي. What is the difference between حديث نبوي and حديث قدسي? What is the difference? Who can tell me? Yes, brother.
حديث قدسي, it's Allah is talking, and حديث نبوي is a prophet.
نعم, جزاك الله خير. The حديث نبوي is by the رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم tongue. He is the one saying it. It's a مسألة. It's something happened. It's something he is explaining. But حديث قدسي is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying it in the tongue of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the tongue of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كل عمل ابن آدم له. Every single action, every single deed that you do in Islam, it's for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward it for you. إلا الصيام فإنه لي. Except the fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's for me. When you fast for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You could be hiding, eating behind the people. You could be saying I'm fasting and you're not fasting. The siyam is a very sincere ibadah between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, إِلَّا الصِّيَامْ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِيبُ. The fasting is for me, and I am the ones who gives the rewards for the fasting. وَالصِّيَامُ جُنَّةٌ. What is the meaning of jannah? الصِّيَامْ protects you from the evil, protect you from the ma'asi, protect you from the bad things. When you look back home, or a lot of sisters, maybe she doesn't wear hijab, and when Ramadan comes, you see her putting her on hijab. Some brothers, they smoke, and when Ramadan comes, they quit smoking. Ramadan is the month of ta'at. It doesn't mean we should just do it in Ramadan, no. But it is the month that the ma'asi is not as the other month. So, إِلَّا الصِّيَامْ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ وَالصِّيَامُ جُنَّةٌ. It means a siyam protects you from the ma'asi. فَإِنْ كَانَ يَوْمُ صَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as the Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala said, فَإِنْ كَانَ, if it is the fasting that you are fasting that day, you're performing your fasting, فَلَا يَرْفُثْ. Do not say bad words. Do not use your tongue badly. Do not backbite. Do not use it in anything bad. فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَصْغَبْ. What does that mean? فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَصْغَبْ. It means do not scream. Do not at home. Be humble. Be nice to the people. فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَصْغَبْ وَلَا يَجْهَلْ. It means لا يسفه لا تكن سفيه. سفيه is the fool person. Just say things. Don't was saying. Just talk. وَلَا يَسْفَه. As رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فَإِنْ شَاتَمَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ. What happened if the person starting being rude to me, start saying bad things to me, start using bad language with me? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us something nice. فَإِنْ سَابَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ شَاتَمَ. Somebody told you something bad, something, somebody told you something you don't like, say اللهم إني صائم. اللهم إني صائم. Oh Allah, I am fasting. اللهم إني صائم. This is what Rasulullah says. Why? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't want you to lose the reward of fasting. The reward of fasting is really big. The reward of fasting is really great. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't want you to lose this reward. فَإِنْ سَابَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ شَاتَمَهُ فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي صَائِمْ وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is swearing, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَخَلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَطْيَبُ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. Sometimes you're fasting, people tell you, oh, your breath stinks, your mouth stinks. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling you, this smell to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the bearer of the smell of the musk. When you smell, you say, oh, mashallah, what a beautiful smell. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this smell, because it's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is better to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the smell of the musk. لَخَلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَطْيَبُ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. And there is a lot of hadith of the benefits and the reward of a siyam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of the hadith, one of the important, this is in hadith in Bukhari, لَا يَصُومُ عَبْدٌ يَوْمًا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بَاعَدَ اللَّهُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ النَّارِ سَبْعِينَ خَرِيفًا. If you fast one day for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will move the hellfire away from you 70 خريفة. It could be like 70 years the hellfire would be far away from you. There is parts, there is aqsam, there is different types of asiyam. The first one, fardun wa tatawwa. So there is two types of siyam. Fard, obligation. a fasting that every single one of us should perform, unless we said there is an excuse for that. So the first one is siyamu fard, farida. Siyamu farida, sawm Ramadan is siyamu farida. Siyamu tatawwu' is the voluntarily fasting. I am fasting Monday and Thursday. And actually, every type of fasting has different rules. So for example, the fasting of Ramadan and fasting during Ramadan, I can't just break my fasting because of something small here and there, or I'm feeling thirsty, or this and that. No. But siyam al-tatawwa', if a person come to visit me at home and I'm fasting on Monday, my mother came to my house and she's actually visiting me and I'm fasting voluntarily. The sunnah is to break your fast ikraman for your dhaif, to be nice to your guest is to break your fast. This is siyam al-tatawwa'. As Prophet ﷺ said, hurru nafsi, you are free for that. You want to continue, you want to fast, it is up to you at the end of the day. But when it comes to siyam al-faridha, no. There is rules, there's conditions, there is things that you have to follow to make it a proper fasting. So siyam al-fard, faridha, an obligation, and there is siyam al-tatawwa', which is the voluntarily siyam, the sunan that you are doing. وَالْفَرْضُ يَنْقَسِمُ ثَلَاثَةُ أَقْسَامُ. And the fard has three types under it as well. The faridha, the obligation. First, sawm Ramadan, the siyam of Ramadan. Siyam al-kaffarat, if I have kaffara, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to do something and I didn't do it. Then there is fasting in here. There is different types of kaffara that I have to do. So this is an obligation as well. This is something I have to do. And every single type of those siyam we will come through. The third type of fasting, it's called siyam al-nadr. What is sawm al-nadr? I say that I did nadr. What does nadr means? I say if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did this to me, I will fast. If inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure my mom and she becomes okay, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her shifa, I'm going to fast 10 days. Then you have to fast 10 days. If you say inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me succeed in this business, in this work, in this matter, and I'm going to fast 5 days, then you have to fill those 5 days and you have to fast them, and they become an obligation on you. This is siyam al-nadr. I have said that I'm going to do this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sawm Ramadan. Sawm Ramadan is faridha, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Faridha is like wajib. Like wajib, same. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum al-siyamu, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. And this ayah has a meaning here, subhanAllah. It's not mentioned in the book. But when we look at it, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, oh, those who believe, fasting Ramadan is an obligation on you as it was for the people who were before you? Because might somebody come and when you say, ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam, a person would say, oh, why only this ummah has to fast? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it an only obligations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ummah? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't leave a chance for this. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. So as-siyam wasn't only at the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Was not only at the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we all know that. Sayyidina Musa, that day of Ashura, when Rasulullah came and he found the people who followed Prophet Musa who were fasting, and he said, why they were fasting? They said, because this day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected Prophet Musa from Fir'aun. So the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh, نحن أولى بموسى منهم. We are the one should be fasting this. We are the one should be doing that more than them. This is one of the things. Siyam Nabiullahi, as the man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I wanted to fast every day. He said, you cannot do that. He cannot do that. He said, Ya Rasulullah, then I want to fast this and that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to make it easy for him, and he told him, if you want to do that, then do as this prophet, he used to fast every single, so he would leave a day and he would fast the other one every single day. Nabiullahi Dawood, he used to fast every single day. So, and this companion, actually, when he took this, he, after he fasted this and he reached old, he said, I wished that I heard the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was so hard for him to fast every single day. Rasulullah said, this is the most you can do, that you fast every... And this is tatawwa. We are not talking about obligations. He came to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to fast all of my life. He said, no. He said, Ya Rasulullah, then this and that. He said, if you want to do, then like Nabiullah Dawood every single day. And this companion, as we just said, when he did it, he said, I wish if I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's advice. The sunnah, the proof from the sunnah, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we all know that hadith, the Islam was built in five pillars. Bunya al-Islamu ala khams, shahadatu an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, wa iqamu as-salah, wa ita'u az-zakah, wa sawmu ramadhani, wa hajju al-bayti liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. So, sawm is one of the pillars of Islam. Bunya al-Islamu ala khams. A man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, Ya Rasulullah, do I have any obligations from fasting rather than the month of Ramadan? Rather than Ramadan, he said, no. It is only Ramadan is the faridah that he has, everybody has to do it, unless you do some tatawwa. If you want to do some voluntarily fasting, it's up to you. But the obligation, one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it for this ummah, is the month of Ramadan. Siyamu Ramadan. قال شهر رمضان. He asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do I have to do anything else? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إلا أن تطوع. Unless you volunteer, this is up to you. What is the reward? What is the benefit of the month of Ramadan? عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه said that when Ramadan came, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is a blessing month. قد جاءكم شهر مبارك. افترض الله عليكم صيام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it an obligation for the ummah of Prophet Muhammad to fasting. تُفَتَّحُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ الْجِنَانِ تُفَتَّحُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ الْجِنَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the door of the jannah, of the jinan, the paradise. وَتُغَلَّقُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ النِّيرَانِ. And the doors of the hellfire closed. وَتُصَفَّدُ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chain the shaitans. Shaitan. So this is the most month, the most time and moments that we should be trying to get out benefit from it. The month of Ramadan. تصفد فيه الشيطان الشياطين وتغل فيه الشياطين فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر من حرم خيرها فقد حرم. If you're really among the losers, then you don't fast the ليلة القدر. So you are losing if you miss Ramadan, that you are among the losers. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he mentioned, there's one night better than 1,000 months. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, and this is hadith in Bukhari, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتساب. Because a person could be fasting Ramadan because you know it is Ramadan and you know everybody is fasting, so I just have to do it because everybody is doing it. I have to do it because I can't actually basically eat in front of my wife and children. I just have to do it because it's... No. Man sama, look at that. Man sama Ramadana imanan. Imanan, believing with the faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for that. Man sama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaban. Ihtisaban, waiting for the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ihtisaban bima inda Allahi minal ajr. You are waiting for the reward and knowing and believing that you are getting a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for fasting this month. What's the continue of the hadith? غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. What is تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ means? Who can tell me? نعم, the advance, the coming sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive it. There is different opinions between the scholars. Will Allah forgive his major sin? Will Allah forgive his saghair? No, the scholar said the saghair, the little thing. I said something, I said a bad word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah forgive it. I did this and that. But for example, a person will fast Ramadan and say, oh, alhamdulillah, Ramadan is gone. Let's go back to the major sin. And he start going eating riba and drinking this and that. And he think because he fast Ramadan, Allah will forgive him. No, we don't deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this way. So this is not the meaning of it. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أفطر يوما في رمضان في غير رخصة رخصها الله له لم يقض عنه صيام الدهر كله وإنصام. Subhanallah. This is very, it shows for the people who are careless about fasting Ramadan. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is warning you and warning us and warning every single person in this ummah. Whoever break his fast for them in one of the days in the month of Ramadan for no excuse, for no reason, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling you, if you fast at dahr, the whole year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept it from you. If you fast the whole year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not take it, لم يقطع عنه, it will not cover the day that you have broken your fast without a valid excuse. A person just feeling, woke up in the morning and he's feeling, oh, he missed this type of food, and he start eating. Then he thinks that, oh, you know what, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you fast at dahr, a year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not, this day will not cover the days that you have broken. Inshallah, the hilal, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man absara al-hilal, when we see the hilal, then this is the starting of the month. Arkanu al-sawm, the pillar of al-sawm. لِصِيَامِ رُكْنَانِ, there is two things that the fast cannot be valid without. The first thing, الْإِمْسَاكُ عَنِ الْمُفْتَرَاتِ, I have to hold myself from eating مِنْ وَقْتِ الْفَجْرِ إِلَى غُرُوبِ الشَّمْسِ, from the morning, from the Fajr till the sunset, till al-Maghrib. لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى فَالْآنَ بَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ. So الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ means the morning, and the bayad or sawadu al-layl is the maghrib. The second thing that the siyam cannot be valid without is the niyyah. And we always mention this in our halaqas. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ. And we know the companion that he did the hijrah because of one of the women's, and one of the ladies, he did the hijrah, he wanted to marry her. So that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. Depends on your niyyah, this is what you get from the reward. This is what you get. You do it for Allah, you do it for the reward, you do it for this, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then no, I'm doing this because of my wife, I do it because of my children, I do it. Yes, there is things, it could be comes under the niyas, it could be from that, but it was for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing has to be for Allah. Anything I do in this life, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Anything I do in this life is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I respect my mother and father, I treat them nicely because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I come to the masjid because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do this good thing because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because of the humans. Whatever you do with the human, you will never please them. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is thankful when you do a good deed. So the first thing you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِي. They were only command to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا عَبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ. Sincerely from your heart, the niyyah is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, who should perform siyam? يجب الصيام على المسلم. The kafir doesn't have to fast. البالغ, when he reached the age of obligation, the age that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question him, when the sister, when the girl get the period, and the boy as well reach the age of an obligation, that this is the age that he should be fasting. We should try our best to try to teach our children to make them practice for fasting, so when they grow up, they're able to do it. So the first one, fasting an obligation on a Muslim, al-baligh, al-aqib, the person who actually can realize. So a crazy one, a person whose mind is not him, he doesn't have to fast. Al-Muslim, al-baligh, al-aqil, al-sahih, the person who have his health. If the doctor tell you I can't fast, khalas, you can't fast. Either he's a Muslim or a kafir, it doesn't matter. He told you, you cannot fast, you cannot fast. So a doctor that you trust, tell you, wallahi, you have this type of disease, or you have a dangerous diabetes, or you have this and that, you cannot fast, then you don't have to fast. As-sahih, al-muqim. If I'm traveling to Dublin today, or I'm traveling to somewhere that is really tiring, I'm taking a plane, traveling to Pakistan, to Egypt, I don't have to fast. I have a rukhsa. I can eat and drink and then perform this day before the next Ramadan, any day before Ramadan, because we're going to come to these masail. If I miss one day in Ramadan because I'm traveling, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. Yes, you have to do it in another day. But be careful. If you don't do it during this day, this year, and another Ramadan comes, oh, there is another story there. Inshallah, we will be coming through those masail. So if I have fasting from last Ramadan, I was sick, I was traveling, I couldn't do it, any excuses that I was supposed to be breaking my fast for, I should perform my fasting before this coming Ramadan. This come for the brother or for a sister, the same. So al-Muslim, al-Baligh, al-Aqil, al-Sahih, person who have his health, he can do it. Al-Muqim, the person who is actually not travelers, because travelers doesn't have to do it. Wala Marib, sick person, he doesn't have to do it. Musafir, travelers can don't have to do it. A woman who has the period, she doesn't fast. The woman when she delivers the baby and the blood of that comes with a nifas, she doesn't have to fast. Sheikh Kabir, an old man, he cannot do it, then he doesn't do it. Hamil, a woman who is pregnant and she has a baby and this could be affecting the baby, she could be doing it in another days. Wala murda, a woman who is feeding her little one, she's breastfeeding him and she cannot fast, then she doesn't have to fast. So there is different people, different types. The people who doesn't have at all, the kafir, the crazy, the person who is not, he has no mind, he doesn't, crazy one, or al-kafir, he doesn't have to fast at all. Siyam al-kafiri wal-majnoon. Asiyamu ibadatun islamiyya. He's saying fasting is actually an ibadah, an Islamic ibadah, Islamic performance, so the kafir doesn't have to do it. And the majnoon, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't ask him in the day of judgment for what he has done. So he wouldn't be asked, so he doesn't have to fast. Siyam al-sabi. He's telling here, the Sheikh is telling, he is not, doesn't have to do it, but as you are a father or a mother, you should be practicing with your little one to teach him, because if you let him go, and then when he comes to reach to the age of an obligation, 13 and 14, and say, listen, now you have to fast, and you become strict on him, and you start treating him badly, he's going to hate it like this. Everything has to be stepped. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he started, when the da'wah came, when Islam came, the companion, there was, people were drinking at that time. They were drinking alcohol. They were, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came with Rasulullah with sunnah al-tadarruj, steps. The sunnah of steps means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first told him, okay, listen, do not drink and go for salah. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la taqrabu as-salata wa antum sukara. Till you realize what you're knowing. This is the first one came. So they are not allowed to drink and go and pray. Yes? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that is telling, this is from the shaitan, try to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end, the last one said, إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجِسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. That's it. Stop it. Be away from it. خلاص. إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجِسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. This is a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the second one, in the first one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not perform salah while you're fasting, while you're drunk. The second one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِثْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ نَفْعِهِمَا. The ithm, the evil from it, the bad things that you get out behind it is bad than what you think that there is might benefit out from that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then told him, no, stop it, it is done. So this is what we should do with our children. Even with nasiha, I have spoken a lot about this. So if I want to teach my child from the when he is young, make him fast half a day before he becomes the age of obligation one day, and let him go for the other day. So step by step, and tell him the reward. Teach him the reward. Don't always, some of the parents, when they teach the children, they tell them, listen, if you don't pray, you're going to go to the hellfire. No, ya akhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never, sent Prophet ﷺ to teach the people like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Musa to Fir'aun. He was a man and he said this and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, told him, be nice to him. Tell him soft words. Advise him nicely. And Rasulullah said, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told him, ya Muhammad, walau kunta fadhal ghalidh al-qalbi, lam fadhu bin. If you are tough, if you're being mean with them, then you won't find them around you, ya Muhammad. So when we teach our children, we teach them in the first place to love Islam, to tell them the reward, to tell them the benefit. And at the end of the day, there is different ways, there's different, a lot of many things that we could teach them the way. Not to teach them, okay, you don't fast Ramadan, You're going to go to the hellfire with the... No, this is not the way we should be. That's why we should let them practice when they are young. Teach them when they are young. عن الربيع بنت معوذ قالت أرسل رسول الله صبيحة عشراء إلى قرى الأنصار من كان أصبح صائما فليتم صومه من كان أصبح مفطرا فليصم. And she's saying that النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told them whoever is fasting, he didn't eat since yesterday, okay, you can continue your fasting, and whoever doesn't, that is okay. Inshallah, stop here because there is only 10 minutes for salat. La 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 la